time is in the street, you know. Us living as we do, upside down. And the new word to have is revolution. People don't even want to hear the preacher spill or spiel, because God's whole card has been thoroughly peeped. And America is now blood and tears instead of milk and honey. The youngsters who were programmed to continue fucking up woke up one night digging Paul Revere and Nat Turner as the good guys. America stripped for bed and we had not all yet closed our eyes. The signs of truth were tattooed across our often-entered vagina. We learned to our amazement the untold tale of scandal. Two long centuries buried in a musty vault, hosed down daily with a gagging perfume. America was a bastard, the illegitimate daughter of the mother country, whose legs were then spread around the world, and a rapist known as freedom, free doom. Democracy, liberty, and justice were revolutionary code names that preceded the bubbling, 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 bubbling in the mother country's crotch. And behold, a baby girl was born, nurtured by slaveholders and whitey racists. It grew and grew and grew, screwing indiscriminately like mother, like daughter, everything unplagued by her madam mother. The present mocks us. Good black people with keen memories set fire to the bastards who ask us in a whisper to melt and integrate. Young, very young, teeny bopping, revolt on weekend young, dig by proxy what a mental ass kicking they receive through institutionalized everything and vomit up slogans to stay out of Vietnam. They seek to hide their relationship with the world's prostitute, alienating themselves from everything except dirt and money, with long hair, grime, and dope to camouflage the things that cannot be hidden. They become runaway children to walk the streets downtown with everyday black people, sitting on the curb crying because we know that they will go back home with a clear conscience and a college degree. The irony of it all, of course, is when a pale-faced SDS motherfucker dares look hurt when I tell him to go find his own revolution. He wonders why I tell him that America's revolution will not be the melting pot, but the toilet bowl. He is fighting for legalized smoke, a lower voting age, less lip from his generation gap, and fucking in the street. Where's my parallel to that? All I want is a good home and a wife and a children and some food to feed them every night. Back goes pale face to basics. Does little orphan Annie have a natural? Do Sluggo's kinks make him a refugee from Mandingo? What does Webster say about soul? I say, you silly trait motherfucker, your great-grandfather tied a ball and chain to my balls and bounced me through a cotton field while I lived in an unflushable toilet bowl. And now you want me to help you overthrow what? The only truth that can be delivered to a four-year revolutionary with a hole card, i.e. skin, is this. Fuck up what you can in the name of Piggy Wallace, Dickless Nixon, and Spiro Agnew. Leave Brother Cleaver and Brother Malcolm alone, please. After all is said and done, build a new route to China if they'll have you. Who will survive in America? 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 You will not be able to stay home, brother. You will not be able to plug in, turn on, and cop out. You will not be able to lose yourself on Skag and skip out for beer during commercials because the revolution will not be televised. The revolution will not be televised. The revolution will not be brought to you by Xerox in four parts without commercial interruptions. The revolution will not show you pictures of Nixon blowing a bugle and leading a charge by John Mitchell, General Abrams, and Spiro Agnew to eat hog maws confiscated from a Harlem sanctuary. The revolution will not be televised. The revolution will not be brought to you by the Schaefer Award Theater and will not star Natalie Woods and Steve McQueen or Bullwinkle and Julia. The revolution will not give your mouth sex appeal. The revolution will not get rid of the nub. The revolution will not make you look 5 pounds thinner because the revolution will not be televised, brother. There will be no pictures of you and Willie Mae pushing that shopping cart down the block on the dead run or trying to slide that color TV into a stolen ambulance. NBC will not be able to predict the winner at 8:32 on Detroit from 29 districts. The revolution will not be televised.
There will be no pictures of pigs shooting down brothers on the instant replay. There will be no pictures of pigs shooting down brothers on the instant replay. There will be no pictures of Whitney Young being run out of Harlem on a rail with a brand new process. There will be no slow motion or still life of Roy Wilkins strolling through Watts in a red, black, and green liberation jumpsuit that he has been saving for just the proper occasion. Green Acres, Beverly Hillbillies, and Hooterville Junction will no longer be so damn relevant.